But so be it. But I, 47 years of marriage, if I said 40, you'd be mad at me for saying that. You know, the essential message is this. There are certain values that are very important. Values of respect for each other, values of equity, values of giving everyone an opportunity to succeed. And sometimes we forget the whole history of Pennsylvania and the reason that this Commonwealth was founded. Remember, William Penn was in jail much of the time in the United Kingdom. However, his father had been an admiral, and the king owed his father a lot of money. But the king didn't have much money, but he had all the land in the United States. So the deal was, all right, you get out of jail, I'll pay your, the debt to your father who was admiral, and we'll give you all these acres in Pennsylvania. But a couple of weeks ago, we had a chance, some of us in the legislature, to see the original Penn's charter. And as you read it and as you understand Penn, you understand that there were some fundamental principles upon which this Commonwealth was founded. The most important of which is this was going to be a place where all would have an opportunity to succeed. This was going to be a place where we would be respectful and we would preach, in essence, the acceptance of all religious faith and all points of view. And we see this fundamental notion of tolerance, respect, civility being challenged today, don't we? We see it being challenged on the national level, and we see it being challenged on the state level as well. I often have good times in the Senate reminding my colleagues of why we were founded and what is it, why, and our purposes. We have some very famous paintings in the Senate chamber. And these paintings were done by a lady named Violet Oakley, who didn't live far from where we are now. And she was the first woman in the United States to receive a public commission. And Miss Oakley was a very interesting lady. She was now considered one of the great muralists of the 20th century. And the murals were painted on the history of our Commonwealth. She was a Christian Scientist who had fun, but she also was a Quaker at the same time. Interesting combination if you know the history of both based traditions. Within her paintings and within the history that she shows in the paintings is something that is very valuable and something that we should be very proud of. And this, the whole notions upon which that we were founded, and something we need never to forget, and we as Democrats don't forget. You know, there's two ways to look at the economy, and there's two ways to look at how you get a nation to move. One is you give everything to the top, and eventually it drips down to the bottom. The trouble is, you don't get very many trips on the bottom. Sometimes you get none at all. The other way, as Kennedy used to say, is to try to raise all ships together. Because when you raise all ships together, then we all prosper and we all go forward. See, there's a choice, isn't there? The choice is we can all withdraw from the society, be very greedy and just get as much money and anything we want. Or the choice is that we can understand that we are all one people, one Commonwealth, and when we share, and when we give everyone an opportunity to participate in the harvest that we're blessed with, then we all grow, and then we all prosper. And so I think what I'm trying to say to you is that there's a reason to be a Democrat. There's a reason to support the colleagues, my colleagues. There's two Americas. You know, by training, I'm a history professor. One America has been an America that where the rich get richer and the rest of us are sort of pushed aside. The other America has always been an America where we recognize the American dream, the opportunity for each and every one of us, hasn't there been? And you see this in our history, don't you? You saw the Gilded Age that was followed by the Progressive Era. You see the excesses of the 20s that was followed by the New Deal. And I believe that what you're seeing today is that the excesses of the first decade of this century is ultimately will be followed by reform and by change, because we've been very fortunate that the pendulum has always swung back to the middle. Now, I don't think you should be surprised by Donald Trump either, because even back in the 19th century, remember the populist movement was, while it was for a, originally was an integrated movement, the people who didn't want it to work separated blacks and whites from working together, and eventually, became together through the progressive movement. So what we're facing now is an attempt by those who have the power and the influence to split us, to split progressives from coming together as one. They're going to split us on class lines. They're going to split us on religious lines. They're going to split us on race lines. But we know as Democrats that this nation stands and this Commonwealth stands for something that can't be split, right? We know that we have something that's very valuable that has to be preserved and saved, and that we can give to the next generation. So I say all that because what I see it going on in Harrisburg and in Washington is that the Republicans who are in control are not our Chester County Republicans who we knew as moderates, who we knew that we so often could work with to get open space, to get good schools, but it's a whole new breed of people, whole new breed of politicians who divide, conquer, and who reject many of us from full participation. So, I see this going on all around us. Let me give you just two or three examples and then I'll stop. And you're lucky, I never stop on my voice. Yesterday in the House, there's a resolution to set back choice by going from 24 months to 20 months to change the law in Pennsylvania when you can't have when you know are going to have an abortion or other things put in there to hurt Planned Parenthood. That resolution was signed by 101 members of the House as co-sponsors, which is one less than they need to get it through. I'm not talking about a vote. I'm talking about simply people who signed and put their names down, all right? As co-sponsors and wanted to be known that they were co-sponsors. We still have not been able to get legislation in this state, and it's now harder than it was before, that would protect gay people and people of different sexual orientations. And we're one of the few states that doesn't have that fundamental part. Our Human Relations Commission can protect you on race, it can protect you on ethnicity, on religion, but it cannot protect you on sexual orientation because this Commonwealth refuses to pass the bills that I and others have signed on to as co-sponsors. Very far different than what William Penn taught us, right? Or today, for those of you who are teachers, a bill was presented, which is SB 805. This bill essentially would end tenure. The bill essentially would end the notion of seniority. This bill would utilize these tests and the results of these tests as a way, as almost the sole way to evaluate teachers. Now, unfortunately, and it was close, but we couldn't defeat the bill, but we were able to amend the bill to put it off until 2018. And one of the reasons we could amend it and put it off to 2018, it would have passed otherwise, was because the Democrats stayed solid, we had a number of Republicans who joined us, and because what has happened is, once we got rid of the graduation requirement, there's some questions about how we're supposed to evaluate schools in the first place. You see what I'm saying? But what I'm trying to tell you to put everything together is those three examples from a simple day. People came in to me about, more interested in open space and land. And I tried to explain to them, you're next. You have to understand. If everything is based on what you're willing to spend, and that's the sole criteria, if we no longer have to worry about whether our schools succeed or don't succeed, all right? If we're going to base education on debt, if we refuse to stand up for people who are different and we're not tolerant anymore of sexual orientation or other issues, if we are willing to ignore the fundamental diversity and respect. This university, for example, until last week, there was no money for this university. But 25% of the payment for the university comes out of the state. And so even in protecting this university, it became very difficult. Because you see, Penn State and Pitt, they only need 5% comes, their total budget comes from the state. Temple's only about 10%. So I had to go out there and argue. And the only way, so those of you understand it, the only way to finally save and make sure the university got is 25%, because you understand 5% you can survive on. Penn State will live whether they get to 5% out. Lincoln would not. Was actually to have to vote for the budget as it was. Because we had in this Commonwealth, in Luzerne County, the notice has already gone out to close the schools in 60 days. And throughout this Commonwealth, you would have schools closed. We had social service agencies that no longer could afford it. Someone had to get into the middle and say enough was enough to both the R's and to the governor as well. No matter, you might have very good ends, but if your means were hurting the very people you had the ends for, then you have to say, you have to say it's time for people to understand the notion of consensus. Remember the Quakers taught us, we can work it out. But to work it out, you have to be willing to accept compromise. And no one up there is willing to accept compromise, which makes it even harder for us to achieve it. So I'm finished, but in essence, and I'm short tonight, but you all know me. But listen, stay as Democrats. I know you will. Support the candidates who are here. And understand and be proud of what you represent now and historically. Because we are the real America. We are the real Pennsylvanians who are carrying on what William Penn said. And when we communicate to people in an effective way, they're coming with us. Because remember in history, we're in a period that is negative, but in our history, it's always been followed by a period that is progressive and one which opens once again the possibilities of the American dream. Thank you so much.